Hi, my name is Brittanye Jackie Mackey, and my pronouns are she, her, hers. I had the honor of directing the incredible play you are about to see called Water Gun Song.
Are you listening?
Mm-hmm.
You just press a button and whoosh! Just by pressing a button, Cindy has the best toys.
That's great, Sam.
Yeah, so awesome. So awesome. And that's not all.
No.
They have a cat and a dog and an iguana. Can you believe it?
And an iguana?
Yep. An iguana. His name is Ivan. Ivan Iguana. Guess what the cat's name is?
Yeah, that's real nice.
Are you listening?
I am. Yes, I am.
I asked you what the cat's name is, and all you said was, that's real nice.
I misunderstood you. I'm listening. See? Put my phone down.
The cat's name. Guess.
What is the cat's name?
Try and guess.
Furball?
No. Obama.
Really?
Yep.
Cat's so cute.
Yeah, because the cat's half white and half black.
I'm sorry, what?
Some of the cat's fur is black and some is.
Sure. Yeah, I get it.
It's so much fun at Cindy's house.
Mm-hmm. How are Cindy's parents toward you?
What do you mean?
How do they treat you?
What do you mean?
Are they nice to you?
Of course they're nice to me.
Do they ever say anything that makes you uncomfortable?
No, Cindy is my friend.
Because you can tell me if they do. Matter of fact, I need you if they do.
It's okay, we just have fun. Hey, you know what else?
What else?
We had a huge water fight.
Oh yeah?
It was so cool. Cindy's mom filled this bucket with water balloons and buckets, and you know what else?
What else? What else?
Ooh, nothing.
Well, now you got me all curious. Tell me.
Ooh, nothing.
Was it water guns? Was it water guns, Sam? Hey, it's okay. I'm not mad.
You're not?
No, I understand. You're having fun.
It was so much fun.
And when you're at someone else's house, that's fine.
It was so much fun. Cindy has this one that shoots water so far.
Oh, yeah?
So far.
But Cindy knows that when she comes here, we don't do that, right?
Yeah, I told her that.
You did?
Yeah, I told her and her mom and her dad.
And what did they say?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Nope. They just did like this.
Well, what did you say?
Well, then we don't play water guns at my house.
Did you say why?
No.
Well, Sam, you have to say why.
I don't know why.
Of course you know why.
I don't know why.
Sam, come on. We've talked about this.
No, I don't understand. A water gun is plastic and it's colorful and it shoots water and it's not real.
But it's a gun.
some guns light up and make noise like space alien guns.
Do you remember when it was our day to bring snacks to your home class? We made sure to find something everyone could eat, right?
Yeah.
Why do we do that?
Because some kids can't have dairy or gluten or meat.
We did that to be considerate of other people's allergies. You know what happens when people's allergies act up?
They don't feel good.
Right. They don't feel good. They get sick. Well, guns make me feel a little sick. Even if it's a toy gun, if it has a barrel and trigger, I have a reaction.
What kind?
Do you know how some nights you have bad dreams?
Yeah.
I have them sometimes. In the daytime. Even when I'm awake and when I think of you with guns. Even if it's a toy, I have quick bad dreams in my head.
What kind?
Something happens when toys are in the hands of children. Especially little brown-skinned children like you.
What happens to them?
Sometimes grown-ups can't tell the difference between something being a toy and something being real, even if you're playing. Not everybody is in on the game.
Oh. I have an idea.
What's your idea?
To let everyone know it's just a game, let's sing a song.
What kind of song?
The water gun song.
How's the water gun song go?
Water gun, it's so fun, it's so fun. Sing it with me, sing it with me.
Water gun, it's so fun, it's so fun.
It's just a game, it's not real, it's just pretend, it's not real.
It's just a game. It's not real. It's just pretend. It's not real.
Maybe that would help.
Maybe. Either way, I like it.
So when you have bad dreams, you can sing that song.
Okay.
Hey, you know what else?
Hey, you know that Obama, the person, not the cat, is more than just his color, right?
Of course.
Okay. Just making sure.
Oh, nunchucks. Can I have nunchucks in the house?
We'll talk about it.
Hey, you know what else?
Water gun. It's so fun. It's not real. It's just pretend. It's not real. Water gun. It's so fun. It's not real. It's just pretend. It's not real. Water gun. It's so fun. It's not real. It's just pretend. It's not real.
Hi everyone, I'm Rosalind Bevan and I'm the director of Act Free by Idris Goodwin. Thank you so much for joining us today and I hope you enjoy Act Free.
Guess what?
What?
You won't believe it.
Believe what?
I was getting a drink of water, and I overheard the higher-ups talking.
They didn't catch you listening to them, did they?
No.
They do not like eavesdroppers.
I know that's right. Seriously, this one time I was listening
to
them.
Listen! So it turns out, we are free.
What?
Free? Seriously, free.
That's not even funny.
It's no joke. I heard him saying it. And it turns out we have been free for a while, but no one told us.
How long of a while?
Days? Months?
Years.
How is that?
Years? What?
Supposed to be someone who was coming to tell us, but then he got lost. Or maybe died in some quicksand or something.
They just sent one person to tell us?
Well, now there's a bunch of troops coming.
How many troops?
How should I know? All I know is that we are free. Which means we don't have to do this anymore.
This? What this?
All this!
So we are free.
Yes!
So I can just walk off right now?
Right now!
And nobody will come after me.
Why would they? You're as free as they are!
Have you talked to the higher-ups about this?
They were talking, trying to figure out how to tell everyone.
How to tell us? What's so hard about just telling us?
Well, I think they're worried that people, the lower than them but higher than us folks, will be scared. Because this has been the arrangement for so long, you know? And people don't like change.
Amen to that.
Change? And mosquitoes.
So when they finally tell us, look surprised because I probably wasn't supposed to say anything.
But if we've been free a while, what's it matter?
What do you mean?
That's a good point. If we've been free this whole time, then we could just go. Right now.
Well, they probably wouldn't appreciate that. As far as they know, we still think we aren't free. So, if you started walking around like you were free, they'd think, hey, what's the big idea?
But you said it. We are free.
You did say that.
Yes, as soon as the higher-ups tell us.
That don't make no sense.
Well, none of this makes sense.
What if we've been free even longer than you hear him say we've been free? What if we are the only gaggle of fools that are thinking they aren't free, all the while everybody else is sipping lemonade and going about their day, jolly as a rabbit in May?
I'm pretty sure that hasn't been the case.
But imagine.
So once they tell us, what are we supposed to do?
Anything we want. Me? I'm gonna get my own land and work it.
Work some land. That's what you do now.
How are you even going to get some land?
You know, there's gotta be some land somewhere nobody's working. What about you?
Not sure. Just be free, I guess. Walk around with my free self. Thinking free thoughts.
Hey, do you think everyone will change how they treat us now that we are free? What? We free now?
Oh, not yet, according to you.
In a few moments, they'll be coming over to read the... I think he called it a charter or something.
Sometimes paper ain't nothing but a dead tree.
Who did you hear that from?
A tree.
You all don't seem excited. I don't understand.
Yes, for us, what does free even mean? Free to do what? What good is it to be free if you don't have anything? The higher-ups, they became higher-ups because their daddies were higher-ups. My mother wasn't free, and her father wasn't free, and his mother wasn't free. They didn't pass down anything to me but bad memories.
That's a good point.
Get land, grow crops, and sell them to who? You think the people who used to be in charge will do business with someone 10 minutes ago they thought was no different than the cow?
You do sound like a cow when you snore.
That's not funny.
They gave you more than bad memories. You're smart. And you're strong. And that's all you need to build anything. Some wits and some muscle.
That's a good point.
Be quiet. Just a minute ago you were agreeing with me.
Okay, okay. Here they come. Here they come.
How should we act?
Just act natural.
What's natural for free people who thought they wasn't?
Shh.
Here they come.
This is it. This is it.
It all?
After this, it'll all be over.
Something tells me it will not be over soon.
Maybe not soon, but it will be over.
Hi everyone, my name is Sarah Shin, my pronouns are she, her, hers, and I had the honor of directing this play about to see next, Nothing Rhymes with Juneteenth.
Hey, what rhymes with Juneteenth?
Oh! That's a hard one. Juneteenth.
I've been sitting here blank for 10 minutes.
What are you doing?
It's for school. We're supposed to present about our favorite holiday.
I thought your favorite was Halloween.
It is Halloween.
So why are you asking to rhyme Juneteenth?
Because this year for Halloween, I'm going as one of the liberation soldiers in 1865 who went down to Galveston, Texas and delivered the message that the enslaved people were free. Did you know it took 2 years after the Emancipation Proclamation?
Wow.
I love soldiers, but I thought, wouldn't it be cool to be one of the soldiers who marched all the way down to Galveston, Texas to deliver the good news to the hundreds of enslaved people?
So your report is not about Halloween?
The report is, but the rap will be about Juneteenth.
Your report is about Halloween and the rap is about Juneteenth.
Exactly. Every kid knows Halloween, but not everybody knows Juneteenth, so putting it in a rap makes sense, right?
Yes, it does.
I just need to think of a rhyme.
Maybe you just rhyme June and then rhyme teeth. So moon and
Moon thief?
Juneteenth, moon thief.
But what does liberating enslaved people have to do with stealing the moon?
Good question. Well, maybe you just try and rhyme the words around them.
I thought of that, but if I can think of a good rhyme for Juneteenth, more people will remember it. That's what rhymes are for.
True.
Juneteenth.
Let me check the rhyming website.
There's a rhyming website?
Yep. Juneteenth.
Is it cheating to use a rhyming website?
Not more or less than using a dictionary. Nope. Nothing rhymes with the Juneteenth. Well, don't get frustrated. We'll figure this out. You know what?
What?
I rapped a little bit in middle school.
Really?
Well, once. My friends and I went as the hip-hop group Arrested Development for Halloween.
Who?
Doesn't matter. We learned one of their songs and performed it for a Halloween school assembly.
You did?
Yep. I think your grandma has a video of it somewhere. I was speech, and I had to learn one of his lyrics. And what I found out was he never actually rhymed the entire word Tennessee. He just rhymed B and C. For some strange reason, it had to be. He guided me through Tennessee. So don't get caught up trying to find the perfect rhyme. There are plenty of ways to make it work.
How?
You tell me. What's Juneteenth?
A celebration
of
being free.
Free rhymes with a lot, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. It does. Here, let me change it.
Ready to try it out?
Okay, so 10, I'm in my Liberation Soldier uniform.
Oh my gosh, you look amazing.
Thank you. Okay. You all know the story of divided states, civil war, bullets and hay, brother versus brother, slave versus master, a bloody chapter of American disaster. Lincoln had a plan to free every man, woman, and girl, enslaving the land. The South said, wait, that's not your call. The war wasn't over, so the news got stalled. 2 years after emancipation, Black people were enslaved. I said Black and not African-American because African-American has so many syllables.
Doesn't matter. Keep going.
Okay, let me start back a bit. The South said, wait, that's not your call. The war wasn't over, so the news got stalled. 2 years after emancipation, Black people were enslaved across the nation. They didn't know the South would lose, and soon they'd get the freedom news. Until then, they stayed in danger, waiting on the troops of General Granger. June 19th was the day. Jubilee, let's celebrate. And word it spread across the South, and that's what Juneteenth is about. So from Texas to Tennessee, hip hop hooray, now we're free. June is here, we are free. Celebrate this day for eternity. We are free, we are free. Juneteenth is here, it's a jubilee. When I say June, you say teenth. Juneteenth. And one more thing I must say, Juneteenth, my real favorite holiday. I just made that last part up in my head just now.
How subversive.
What's subversive mean?
It means that you are the best kind of liberation soldier. And for that, you get ice cream.
You all know the story of divided states, civil war, bullets and hay, brother versus brother, slave versus master, a bloody chapter of American disaster.
Hey everybody, my name is Cyril Amanafo, I use he, him pronouns, and I am the director of this next play entitled Hashtag Matter. I hope that this show resonates with you like it does with me, and I hope you enjoy. Peace.
We live next door to each other, as kids.
And now, same city.
We were never that close during any of it, but we knew each other.
I'd see him here and there.
We were aware of one another.
We kept our space. Not consciously, we just ran in different spaces.
But we were always aware. Social war.
Another name. Another body. Another image has circulated. The newest name. Body. The latest image to haunt.
It's shameful.
I posted, "This is no time for apathy."
I liked it.
The fight for equality continues on.
Liked it.
And then I typed a hashtag in three words, words I thought anyone could get behind.
I didn't quite like that. I responded with a hashtag and three words, nothing offensive, words I thought anyone could get behind.
I didn't quite like it, so I deleted it.
She deleted my response. Totally hypocritical.
My wall, my space, and yeah, I edited it. It's the one space where I can build the world I'd like to inhabit.
I respond to her posts a lot. We share the same algorithm, politically.
My response was to remove it.
Erasure is never okay, so I responded. This is not a race issue, not really. This is about abuse of power.
I responded, "Are you crazy?"
I responded, "We're talking about equality. The human experience now is not a time for stark division along racial lines. This is the time for us to recognize our shared humanity."
I deleted it.
I messaged her.
He messaged me.
We haven't seen each other in a while or spoken. The last time was at this concert, and she was a little mad at me because the MC performed a song with the N-word in the chorus, and she saw me sing along, and she never said anything to me, but after the show, she was cold to me.
He messaged me.
"Hey, Kim. I know it's been a while."
He felt like we needed to talk, needed to clear the air.
"Could we sit down for coffee sometime?" Sitting down.
"I want to ask you what you meant, but I'm finding it hard to ask. What I'd rather do is tell you what I think about what I thought you meant."
"I can explain what I meant."
"I'm sure you can. But can you explain what I read and what I took it to mean?"
"I just meant that we are all comprised of matter. Matter being that essential molecular element of which we are all built. Regular matter, like trees and water, solids and liquids."
"But sound. The voice, for example, wasn't always considered matter. Matter used to only encompass a select set of solid objects."
"But all along, it was all matter."
"What happens to matter split? Does it explode and decimate into millions of bodies of colors? And whose hands split that matter? What we're talking about are black lives split, shaken until they become bombs.
Their lives, those lives, it's all ridiculous. We are here and we can decide how this goes. This doesn't have to, we shouldn't. We don't have to ascribe. And aside, there was that one summer after our senior year of high school. We were both short on credits, all of our friends took off, we had to stick around. We both ended up working at the library to make extra cash. We got kind of close that summer. We talked about books, smoked joints on our lunch break. That was the summer I got into R&B and I turned her on to some indie rock. I thought, man, what a cool chick. There was that one night after our shift. We got those tall cans and decided to break into the school. We heard someone. So we ducked into the only open classroom we could find, the chemistry room. It was dark and we were quiet. We kept drinking and got closer. Maybe it was just that everything was coming to an end. We got close to, but we didn't. She stopped suddenly, said she had to go home. We are on the same side, Kim.
Are we?
Yes. We want the same thing.
After another man is laying in the streets, your immediate impulse is to correct me, to talk semantics with me, to say, oh, well, actually, Kim, I don't know what side that is. An aside. In particle physics, antimatter is material composed of antiparticles, which have the same mass as particles of an ordinary matter, but have an opposite charge.
I don't believe that anyone is more or less or special.
When we say Black Lives Matter, do you think that's us saying we're special? Oh, look at us. We're getting shot.
No, but it's sort of making your suffering worse than others. Not what I meant. What I'm saying is, I mean, what about in Africa? All the Boko Haram stuff. Or women all over the world getting abused, or gays and Hispanics being deported, being shot at the border, or hell, even poor white folks who live in black communities who are for the crimes of others. And I'm all for civil rights, but looting property damage, rage. All lives, Kim. That's all I'm saying. Separate the let's pull it from the context of race and break it down to its root human wickedness.
And sometimes humans kill humans because of their race.
Wouldn't it be great if we could just move on? Just be ourselves, be individuals, our own perfect stars. Just be our own perfect stars. When we were kids, when we'd have a block party, all the kids would go out and their faces painted like Spider-Man, bike races. We were just kids in the neighborhood. When did we all start to...
I was the only black kid at that block party.
I didn't see it like that.
You didn't see I was black.
I didn't treat you different.
But not everybody was like you.
An aside. She was not always like this.
An aside. I was silent. I used to be silent.
She used to be real easygoing. A cool chick.
I used to hold my breath. Breathe shallow up here in my chest.
we grew up the same way.
But the way we are perceived is different.
But that doesn't make those perceptions true.
The tree and the water are in the same forest, but not the same. Different mass, different volume, different uses. Are you willing to decrease your mass? Just say it. Black lives matter.
Do white lives not matter?
Nobody is saying what doesn't matter.
But it's exclusionary.
It's contextual. And its climate, it relates to the splitting of black atoms with no consequence.
And aside, I really want to leave. I feel sick. I want to hug Kim and say I am sorry, and at the same time tell her to just get over it. Life's hard, and there is no measuring stick for suffering. She can make this better just by being herself, not this angry black woman.
And aside, I really want to let Cole off the hook, drop this whole thing, tell him it's all good. But I have swallowed myself so many times to make white folks less uncomfortable.
I just want to fix it.
Cole wants to know how we fix it. Wants me to tell him, but I just woke up this way. I don't know how to dig into the hearts, rewire the circuitry. Who does? All I'm trying to do is keep it together.
I want to tell her I am sorry.
I don't need apologies. I just want it to stop.
To say it is to admit that my life, in someone's eyes, people living, people dead, has mattered more than other folks. And I don't think it does. But someone at some point has believed that. And my life has probably been better because of that.
That night in the chemistry room, when Cole and I got close all those years ago, I was into it. I liked him. Until he put his hands in my hair. I thought about all those kids in school always asking to touch it. Can I touch it? And how they'd react when they did. And he had his hands in my hair. And I wonder how he thought it felt. Weird. Funny, good. Then I thought about if he'd been with any black girls before, and it was too much, so I told him I had to go home. So I did. I left. And that was the closest we ever got.
A week or two later, I sent Kim a message. I thanked her for our conversation. I told her we should be in touch more often. That I wanted to keep talking, not just about this, but about our lives in general. Nothing. That was that, I thought. But one morning I went on my timeline. I saw her picture and her name being shared by everyone. They called it a failure to comply. Failure to be silent. So she was made silent. Forever. She lives on now. The hashtag. But I still hear her voice hanging in the particles. Does a spirit have mass? It must. I can feel the weight.
Old pirates, yes, they rob I, sold I to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jasmine Brooks. My pronouns are she, her, hers, and I am the director of the next play that you're about to see entitled Black Flag.
Fall semester, late August.
Oh, hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, finally in flesh.
I know.
And I'm so used to looking at your Facebook picture, and now here you are.
So excited to meet you.
Yes. So are you ready for this?
I can't wait.
Okay, roomie. So first things first, do you mind if I take this side of the room? It just felt right to me.
All yours.
I mean, we can always switch after Christmas break. I mean, winter recess.
You could say Christmas break here.
You got any more stuff? I can help.
No. I thought I'd set up light. I'm going to be hitting up my mom for them care packages on the regular, so.
Oh, my mom sent me with everything.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I got jars of peaches. I got peanut brittle, and I got moon pies.
Oh, Lord, no. Keep all of that away from me.
you mean these?
Yes, I mean those.
Oh, mm-hmm. You don't like these?
Sydney?
Oh, this right here?
Oh, how dare you! So are you going to the mixer?
Yeah, you?
I don't know.
Oh, come on, you gotta come. I won't know anybody there.
But once you meet people, isn't that the point? I guess your mama really did pack everything for you.
Yeah. Says she wants to make sure I don't forget. Says, don't you get lost out there. She's, got a lot of pride.
A lot of pride?
Yeah. It's like where I come from, you know? It's okay, right? I mean, like, I know it's a little, Southern girl, rebel flag, but, wow, you seem like a rebel to me.
Your side of the room.
Would you mind giving me a hand?
You know what? Actually, I think I...
Hey, I heard that, that cafeteria down there, they got soft serve. You want to come down and get some?
No. I got a lot of stuff here, so.
Okay. Well, you have my number, so text me if you want to hang out.
Yeah, I'll do that.
All right.
Fall semester, November. That's mine.
It was under my lid.
But it's mine.
Well, I thought it was something of mine, so.
Well, it's not. So, you didn't read it, did you? You really shouldn't have read that. Once you saw that it wasn't something of yours, you shouldn't have read it.
Well, I did, so.
She says we have to write about what we're feeling and what's on our mind, and we gotta be honest.
So, this is what you really think?
You really shouldn't have read it.
Well, it's so secretive, but you read it in front of your entire class and your professor?
Come on, Sydney. Didn't you ever think for one second that maybe, just maybe, I might be uncomfortable by this?
But I didn't mean it in like a...
You know, you can... It's your side of the room. You have the right to have whatever you want on your wall.
You said it assaults you. You said this cross burning its Confederate history into my nightmares? Deja! You don't seriously think I'm one of those, like, dumb redneck assholes
that you I never called you a dumb redneck. You have the poem in your hands. I never said anything about you.
This poem is called To My Roommate.
But it wasn't to you. It's a free write. And in a free write, you're supposed to just let your thoughts fall out of your brain. And she said not to censor, and so I didn't.
I didn't realize that when I put it up, like, I did not think of it as something that could be a problem for you.
Of course you didn't.
I don't mean it as... It represents, you know, my home, my culture, the good things, though. Like, I don't mean it, like...
Yeah, it's whatever, okay? Your side of the room.
I don't want you to be uncomfortable.
I said it's whatever.
Okay. All right.
All right.
All right. Last one.
It's all good. You have it.
Semester, December. Is that?
Yeah. My roommate's from the South, and she has a lot of pride.
Was it up when you moved in?
She actually asked me to help her move it, to put it up.
Oh. Really?
Yeah.
No.
Yep. First day, she pulled it out of her bag and hung it up.
Ironically?
It's her side of the room. She can put up whatever, I guess. As long as it's not, like, gory stuff or porn.
So it doesn't bother you? Okay.
Look, I know how this looks.
Yeah, it looks kind of racist.
Her mother gave it to her so she wouldn't forget, you know? Like, where she came from.
Ah. Didn't want her to get lost out here with all these weirdos and godless heathens. Now, honey, when you get out there, don't you go fraternizing with them homos and Arabs. You can bring this up to the school, you know. Tell them you want a different room. I'm for real.
I thought of that at first, but I...
But...
It's not... Okay, this is gonna sound like I'm trying to make a pun. It's not so black and white. Like, I see one thing and she sees something else. It's not clear cut. I mean, I see slavery, obviously, but she just sees like her mama and just like being country and Southern. Mm. You know, you see this flag on like country albums and belt buckles and like, wait, what was that TV show with the car?
I don't know.
My grandpa was always watching it. Something with a car.
I don't know.
Okay, she sees like country pride, like in a real generic way. It just means I'm from the South.
Where they used to enslave African Americans.
You are too much.
Tell me I'm wrong.
Okay, I don't wanna... I just got here, you know? Like, it's my first year of college, and I worked my ass off. And I mean, it's hard enough just trying to... I mean, can I just go to my classes and parties and just like... I mean, do I have to be starting the whole thing because I see something different on her side of the room? I mean, I don't like it. I don't, but I don't like a lot of things I see in here from white folks.
No, I feel you, but...
But, you're always with that. Why do you even care? You ain't black?
Well, Deja, for starters, I hate slavery.
You sure it's not some prejudice against Southerners? Like, based on a bunch of stereotypes? You just assume they're all racist and want slavery back? That's not fair.
No, but...
The flag is just colors and fabric. The meaning changes depending on who's holding it and who's looking at it. I just gotta make it through this first year, and then I can try and get reassigned for some other arbitrary-ass reason. But no, I'm sorry. I'm not gonna be the black girl, the angry black girl who started some shit over a flag. Especially if the girl who put the flag up is like this sweet, bubbly girl who's just trying to stay connected to home. It's gonna start a whole thing. Like, people are gonna be talking all over TikTok and Facebook and putting my picture all over the internet, like giving their opinions.
Yeah. You've given this a lot of thought.
The brochure ain't say nothing about this.
The Boys of Hazzard.
What?
The show. The show you were...
No, wait. Hazzard.
Dukes?
Oh, the Dukes of Hazzard!
Yeah. Right! Yep. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Jesus.
I'm so sorry, Deja. Oh my god, I didn't know you were studying. Who's this, Deja?
I'm Harry.
I'm so sorry.
Sydney, what you been drinking?
Just iced tea.
Just iced tea?
That's from just up the ways in this wonderful place that they call Long Island.
Oh my god. Okay. Sorry, Harry. I think...
No, it's all right. No, I can help you if...
No. Oh no, you too. I don't want to mess things up. I just
like lay down. Like, just like lay down. Did I come here for?
You might want to grab a bucket.
Yeah, you can. Okay.
Wait, what did she say? Herman?
Harry.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what did you say?
Sydney. What did I say?
Sydney.
Something about a bucket?
Yeah, you just look pretty messed up.
Because maybe you don't know me, but
Sydney Blanchard does not peek.
Oh,
God.
Okay. Deja, I'll call you.
Hey. No. Don't go. I didn't mean to interrupt. Oh, I remember what I came here for. Bye, y'all.
Bye.
Harry.
What the hell accent was that supposed to be?
I wasn't doing an accent.
Oh, no. Because it sounded like you were trying to parrot me.
It wasn't, Sid.
Because I know what a fake Georgia accent sounds like, see? Because I'm from Georgia. And when we say bye, we say it just how I said it. Bye. But when you said it, you sounded like you were from Texas or something. Like, bye.
Thank you.
Okay, Sydney. Bye, girl.
Okay, wait. Do y'all want one of these peaches?
No.
No, Sydney.
Suit yourself.
It's a little piece of home right here.
Yep. You got your home all over this place. Peaches and your flag.
Stop it.
What was that, Harry?
Now she remembers my name.
Okay, we're gonna go too. Let's all just get out of this room.
No, I think I want to stay. Right here. With you. And Harry. In my room.
With your flag.
And your flag.
This is a shirt.
Yeah, but it's a flag. And you're walking it around everywhere. California Bear Revolt, all up in everybody's face. See, and mine lives right here in my space, in my private space.
Calm down.
I don't like this guy, JJ. He's Sid. You can do better than this idiot. Oh, is that right, idiot?
You don't call me an idiot, you drunk.
Stop it, both of you.
Call me an idiot. At least I ain't racist.
You don't even know me. You don't even know me.
I know what this is.
Sydney, maybe you just want to calm down. He wasn't...
Oh, don't give me that. Jaysa, you're the one who started all this.
Don't yell at her. You're the one who's being so insensitive, bringing in this flag.
Make me out to be some kind of racist. My best friend in high school was black.
You are racist.
My frat coach.
You have a racist black. Mentality.
You are the one.
That is what you have.
I am not a racist.
Spring semester, early January.
Like, over the winter break, the winter recess, my whole family, cousins and aunties, we met up in Stone Mountain Park, just outside of Atlanta. We have this tradition, day after Christmas, we always go there and, have a picnic and catch up with each other. And there's, trees and, lots of land and, it's real nice. And, of course, a big old plantation house and then a big old museum about the plantation house where they tell you stories about the old times and how things used to be. And then there's Stone Mountain. There's an actual stone mountain staring right down at you and chiseled into the side
there's like all these Civil War guys, like Stonewall and Jefferson and Robert E. And, you know, we grow up hearing stories about these guys like they're saints, like our whole lives. And like my family is not like, you know, like, so like we're at the park and like there's this other family. Well, like really there's like lots of families out there, but like there's this one that I keep overhearing. Well, two guys really. And one of them say that it was right there on that stone mountain where the Klan, like they jump started the Klan, like the Second Coming. They met there on Stone Mountain, and you know, they don't share that with you in that big old plantation museum. And, you know, these guys were talking about action and how these guys weren't afraid to act. And how Dylan Roof,
the South Carolina shooter,
they were saying how they thought he was just a mixed-up kid. And like they don't agree with murder, but didn't he have some balls and he wasn't afraid to take some action? And
my God.
Yeah. And I wanted to walk over there and just say like a million things to them. But I was like, I'm not gonna lie to you, Deja, and pretend like a lot of these so-called liberal kids do, you know, like I've heard shit like it before, but like what really, really hit me was like they started complaining about how after Dylan Roof killed all those people, they took the flag down.
Your flag?
Yes, this flag. They took it down in South Carolina. And these guys, they kept saying like, you know, they better not try and do that here in Georgia. Like that big eared some bitch Obama better not try and take my flag. They're not. And it just kept going from there, you know? And I swear, Deja, I thought about you. And I thought about that night with that Harry.
He's not so bad.
Whatever. I know you guys are booed up now, but I thought about what happened here in this room and that poem you wrote, how you wrote its arms blocking off history from evolving past its scars. And my mama gave me this so that I wouldn't forget her and how she raised me. And now, when I see it, all I see is those guys talking about Dylan Roof and taking action. And oh God, like Deja, it's time. It's got to come down.
Your flag right there.
Yes.
Good.
But, will you help me?
How?
Help me take it down.
Help you take it down? Or take it down for you?
I know you don't want this here. Like, every day you gotta be thinking, like, ugh, I just wanna yank that damn thing.
Sydney.
And I get it now.
Sydney.
I do. Like, do it. Just take it down. Like, it's okay with me.
But it's not okay with me.
But I want
wait,
you.
Wait. Just listen. I don't want to take your flag down for you. See, because if I take it down for you, then the story is it came down because you have a black roommate. because your black roommate felt uncomfortable. It should make you uncomfortable too. It should make anybody uncomfortable. I want you to want to take your flag down. I want those guys in Stone Mountain Park to want to take it down. I want anyone who sees—
Okay.
It has to be you.
Why can't I move? Like, why does it hurt when I try?
It's like you told me. It's where you came from. It's pride.